Have you ever thought about being a millionaire? Or maybe you've been wondering, how do these millionaires do it? What is the secret to becoming a millionaire? In this video, we're going to cover the rules you need to follow to be a millionaire. These are the basic rules that most millionaires have used and became successful at making money and building their net worth to millions of dollars. So hang on tight as we go through all of this. Champions, welcome back to the channel. This is Izu, back again with another valuable video for your financial wellness. And if this is your first time stopping by this channel, welcome. Consider subscribing now to join this amazing community to stay informed on the latest helpful videos for your financial wellness. My goal is to do the research and bring you the awesome contents that will help you with your personal finance and financial success. And if you've been watching these videos but yet to subscribe, be sure to hit the subscribe button now to avoid missing out. One more thing, drop a like on this video to help other people find these videos quicker. Thank you. Okay, let's dive right into it. This video was inspired by this article from MSN. So the number one rule according to this report is never ever spend more than you make. And this is something that so many people get caught up doing. A lot of people out there earn $100 and they spend $105. It doesn't matter how much money you make. If you earn $1,000, $10,000, but you catch yourself spending even a dollar over what you make, you are in for a long haul, because you will basically not be a millionaire spending more than you make. So that's the number one rule. Never spend more than you make. So the second rule is to avoid debt like a plague. So debt is something that hangs over your neck. It's just like a heavy weight that weighs you down. When you're trying to get ahead, debt just keeps pulling you down. It doesn't matter how much or how fast you're running. It just feels like that thing that's pulling you, drawing you back. So the second rule according to this article is avoiding debt like a plague. So at all costs, if you can, avoid debt. Now, to be clear, we have the good debt and the bad debt, right? So the good debt, like I've said before in previous videos, is any debt that puts money in your pocket, while the bad debt is the debt that takes money away from you, a bank mortgage, right? Number three, this article says buy when everyone is freaking out and sell when everyone thinks they can't lose. This is a very valuable advice and a rule I feel like we all need to follow. So whenever you see people freaking out, you need to take action that very instant. Like a wise man once said, I'm not sure who said that, if it was Warren Buffett or someone, but a really wise man once said that. He said, zig when everyone is zagging and zag when everyone is zigging. So this rule basically highlights the importance of you not buying into fear when everyone is basically on the sidelines. You need to jump in the game and take action. So when it comes to investing, you basically want to buy when everyone is afraid and you want to sell when everyone is buying. You don't want to be caught with the bag empty. You don't want to cut with your hands out like that, right? So the goal here is for you to zig when everyone is zagging and zag when everyone is zigging. So number four, you can either try to look rich or be rich. This is a very important rule right here, because a lot of people get caught up in this fake lifestyle where they keep trying to fake it till they make it. Again, nothing wrong with looking nice or looking good, but the problem is the fake it till you make it lifestyle always gets you caught up in the wrong side. So here's the thing, at the end of the day, faking it till you make it might sound like the deal where people are driving cars that they can't afford, living in houses that they can't afford, but this will never get you to a millionaire status. So let's just imagine you have two guys. The one guy has a big car and a nice house and he has $10 in his bank account. Then you have the other guy that has $100,000 in his bank account, but then he has a 15-year-old car and he lives in a smaller house. Who do you think is richer? Most people would think that the guy who has a big house and the big car is the richer guy, right? But the deal is that's not the case. Your goal on your millionaire journey is for you to be rich, not to look rich. So you want to make sure that you don't fall for the trap of having nice things and all that stuff. Nothing wrong with the nice things, but the thing is, the nice things will get you caught up having an empty bank account and appearing like you have it all when you don't have it all. So number five is a very key one. It ties into most of the things we've been talking about so far. And this one says, live like you'll die tomorrow and then invest like you will live forever. This is a very great rule. because when it comes to investing, you have to understand that investing is not a sprint, it is a marathon. And this rule is one that you have to follow if you really want to be a millionaire. And I really enjoy this one because people are in this whole YOLO mentality, you only live once mentality. But if you want to be a millionaire, you want to invest for the long term. That's why it says live like you will die tomorrow, but invest like you will live forever. So you always want to be in a situation where you have enough money. You never run out of money. Even though they live like they will die tomorrow, most millionaires invest like they will live forever. Number six is a rule which says that there are only six ways for you to get rich. And here are the options. You marry money, you inherit money, you exploit a unique talent, or you get exceedingly lucky, like people who win the lotteries, right? Or you own or lead a successful business and you spend less than you make and invest your savings wisely. So there you go. That's the number six for you. So number seven is a very important rule that everybody needs to pay attention to. And number seven says the riskiest thing you do is to take no risk. There's a saying, I can't remember who said that, but it says people are so afraid to fail that they never accomplish anything. And this is a problem that has held back a lot of people from living the life of their dreams or becoming a millionaire. You cannot live your life hoping to take no risk. That is a recipe for disaster. In general, you want to make sure you're taking the right type of risk and not just jumping onto every opportunity that comes your way. Or the worst thing you can do is avoiding those opportunities. So go out there and take calculated risk. Number eight is one that really hits home for me. And this basically says, never make your well-being someone else's responsibility. How often do you see people who neglect themselves or their health, hoping that someday they'll get to their health, or blaming other people for not being healthy? So you want to make sure you're exercising, you're eating right, and you're taking care of your body. Number nine is a very useful one when it comes to investing. So number nine says, when it comes to information, less can be more. So here's the deal with this one. This doesn't mean you shouldn't do your due diligence or you shouldn't try your best to gather as much information as you can before you take any action or before you take any risk or make any investment decision. What this means is that there are people who have let analysis paralysis hold them back from their dreams or their journey of becoming a millionaire. And what do I mean by analysis paralysis? These are the people who know very well what to do. They have been given all the tools and all the resources they need to take action. But these people always get caught up in constant analysis that leads them nowhere. And they keep analyzing to the point where they basically get frustrated and they give up on their dreams and the journey of making millions of dollars. So if you want to be a millionaire, you have to know how to use the minimal information you've gotten to take action. Don't wait until you have all the answers, because the truth is, you will never have all the answers. And that's just how life is. It's hard for you to have all the answers before you take any action. So with the less information you have, or with the number of information that you've been able to gather, take action and make sure you go head on for that thing that you want. So the very last rule here is the one that we hear all the time. In fact, this one has become a cliche. This one is, time is money and money is time. Truth be told, when you see people who have so much time on their hands, it's always certain that they don't have any money. But when you see people who are busy, who are always busy, productive members of the society, these people are one of the highest earning people. And these people never have time for other things that are not productive. So if you want to be a millionaire, you have to understand that time is one of your most valuable assets, and you have to treat it like gold. Everyone has 24 hours in a day. The question lies in what you do with your 24 hours. So ask yourself today, what am I doing with my 24 hours in a day? Am I using my 24 hours in a day to create something productive or something that moves me forward, that moves me closer to my goals or to my net worth that I want to get to? So the action you need to take today is track your time. Take active steps to track your time. Every time you spend, you need to account for the time. All right. There you have it. These are the 10 rules that you have to follow today to be a millionaire. If you have gained some insight from this video, be sure to give this video a thumbs up and share this video to help other people find this video quicker. Don't forget to subscribe now to avoid missing out on the latest helpful videos on this channel. Keep winning and see you in the next video.